light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand.
In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness.
A pleasant evening, sisters and brothers. Welcome to another act of worship with the Pro-Cathedral and the Parish of St. George with St. Barnabas. Our service tonight takes the form of evening prayer, and I pray that we would have all had a wonderful day walking with Jesus. So let us now prepare our hearts for worship. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O Heavenly Father, you give your children sleep for the refreshing of soul and body. Grant to us this gift, we pray. Keep us in that perfect peace which you have promised to those whose minds are fixed on you. And give us such a sense of your presence that in the hours of silence, we may enjoy the blessed assurance of your love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We turn to our prayer books, page 60, the sentence for Epiphany. The Lord has declared his salvation. His righteousness he has openly displayed for all the nations to see. Page 62. Blessed be the Lord our God,
by whose grace we are yet alive.
Blessed be his Son, Jesus Christ,
by whose rising we are set free.
Blessed be the Spirit of God,
in whom is our hope and our joy.
Father, we come together in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, to offer you our worship, praise, and thanksgiving. To you belong all power and glory. You are the source of all goodness. Let our worship be a witness to your peace and saving power. Through your Spirit, may we ever rejoice in the abiding presence of our risen and ascended Lord. Amen. O gracious light, pure brightness of the ever-living Father in heaven, O Jesus Christ, holy and blessed, now as we come to the setting of the sun and our eyes behold the Vesper light, we sing your praises, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You are worthy at all times to be praised by happy voices, O Son of God, O Giver of life, and to be glorified through all the worlds. Lord, we pray to you for the forgiveness of our sins. As we reflect on the day that is now past, we think of the highs and lows of our day. We think of our high moments, our wonderful moments. If at any time we might have disregarded the feelings of others and have allowed our joy to become an occasion for others to stumble. We think of our low moments when we might have been frustrated, upset, and we may have said or acted in an unkind manner. All these we now bring before Almighty God as we seek his forgiveness. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone, and so uphold us by your Spirit, that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We now turn to our Psalms. We have three Psalms this evening. We will read Psalms 12, 13, and 14. Psalms 12, 13, and 14. We begin on page 481. 481. Help me, Lord, for there is no godly one left. The faithful have vanished from among us.
Everyone speaks falsely with his neighbor. With a smooth tongue, they speak from a double heart.
Oh, that the Lord would cut off all smooth tongues and close the lips that utter proud boasts.
those who say, with our tongue will we prevail. Our lips are our own. Who is Lord over us?
Because the needy are oppressed and the poor cry out in misery, I will rise up, says the Lord, and give them the help they long for.
The words of the Lord are pure words, like silver refined from ore and purified seven times in the fire.
O Lord, watch over us and save us from this generation forever.
The wicked prowl on every side, and that which is worthless is highly prized by everyone.
How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me?
How long shall I have perplexity in my mind and grief in my heart day after day? How long shall my enemy triumph over me?
Look upon me and answer me, O Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, lest I sleep in death.
Lest my enemy say, I have prevailed over him, and my foes rejoice that I have fallen.
But I put my trust in your mercy. My heart is joyful because of your saving help.
I will sing to the Lord, for he has dealt with me richly. I will praise the name of the Lord Most High.
The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. All are corrupt and commit abominable acts. There is none who does any good.
The Lord looks down from heaven upon us all to see if there is any who is wise, if there is one who seeks after God.
Everyone has proved faithless. All alike have turned bad. There is none who does good. No, not one.
Have they no knowledge, all those evildoers, who eat up my people like bread and do not call upon the Lord?
See how they tremble with fear, because God is in the company of the righteous.
Their aim is to confound the plans of the afflicted. But the Lord is their refuge.
Oh, that Israel's deliverance would come out of Zion. When the Lord restores the fortunes of his people, Jacob will rejoice and Israel be glad. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Amen. Our first reading from the book of Ephesians chapter 2.
A reading from the Word of God, written in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 2, reading verses 1 through 10. You were dead through the trespasses and sins in which you once lived, following the course of this world, following the ruler of the power of the air, the spirit that is now at work among those who are disobedient. All of us once lived among them in the passions of our flesh, following the desires of flesh and senses, and we were by nature children of wrath, like everyone else. But God, who is rich in mercy, out of the great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead through our trespasses, made us alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved, and raised us up with him, and seated us with him in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the immeasurable riches of his grace in kindness toward us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Amen. We turn to our prayer books on page 67 and we recite the Magnificat, page 67. My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in you, O God, my Savior. For you have looked with favor on your lowly servant. From this day, all generations will call you blessed. You, the Almighty, have done great things for me, and holy is your name. You have mercy on those who fear you, from generation to generation. You have shown strength with your arm and scattered the proud in their conceit, casting down the mighty from their thrones and lifting up the lowly. You have filled the hungry with good things, and the rich you have sent away empty. You have come to the help of your servant Israel, for you have remembered your promise of mercy, the promise made to our forebears, to Abraham and his children forever. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. And now we have our second reading from the book of John, the Gospel of John, chapter 1, verses 35 to 42.
A reading from the Word of God, written in the book of John, Chapter 1, reading verses 35 to 42. The next day, John again was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he exclaimed, "Look, here is the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard him say this, and they followed Jesus. When Jesus turned and saw them following, he said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and see." They came and saw where he was staying, and they remained with him that day. It was about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. One of the two who heard John speak and followed him was Andrew, Simon Peter's brother. He first found his brother Simon and said to him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated anointed. He brought Simon to Jesus, who looked at him and said, "You are Simon, son of John. You are to be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We turn now to our hymn books, provincial hymn books, hymn number 754, 754. Jesus Calls Us, or The Tumult. First reading from the book of Ephesians, we would have heard the words, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing, it is the gift of God, not the result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand to be our way of life." Friends, I want to share with us just briefly a very important understanding of our Christian faith, that even the best of us sometimes miss the point. I use a personal experience where, in a discussion with another person, obviously, we were discussing salvation, and the other person was making the point that salvation is not as free as we think it is. We have to work for it. And he was very adamant, and I was, of course, disagreeing and saying to him, salvation is free. We cannot work for it. And so he posed the question, okay, well, if you're a Christian, don't do any good works and see if you're going to reach heaven. And so that question was something like a trick question. Don't do any good works and see if you're going to reach heaven. Christians are called to good works. And as was read, verse 10 of Ephesians 2, for we are what he has made us, created in Christ Jesus for good works. Created in Christ Jesus for good works. And so to put it in simple terms, I believe, we are created for good works. So we do good works and we perform good works as Christians because we are saved. Our salvation is what moves us to do good works. And that is very, very different from the understanding that we do good works in order to be saved. And I pray that we would get that. As Christians, we do not and we cannot do good works in order to be saved. As Paul writes for us so beautifully, he says, we are saved by grace through faith, and it is not our own doing. It is the gift of God, not the result of works. You get that? It is not the result of works. Our salvation is not the result of works, so that no one can boast. Can you imagine how some people would sound and look and act and behave if we could say that I work for my salvation, I did this and I did that? It would be a terrible mess. We have to understand our salvation is God's free gift to us. And we sometimes trip up over this understanding of good works and how does good work, how does it fit in with our Christian living? And I believe it is simple enough, sisters and brothers. Good works are done because we are saved. It is because of what God in Jesus has done for us why we do good works. And so we do not do good works in order to be saved. We are not doing good works in order to get into heaven. It is because heaven is already assured to us. We do good works. Our good works are an expression of who we are. And so I pray this evening that we would understand this beautiful gift of salvation that our God has brought to us in Jesus. And that we understand in all that we do, it is not for us to gain our salvation, but rather our salvation has been given to us as a free gift from God. And it is because of this gift in our lives that we are encouraged to do good works. It is because of salvation that we want to do good works. And these good works are daily expressions of the salvation that has already been won for us in Christ Jesus. So I pray that little bit of Christian teaching will resound with us, resonate with us, that we understand it, that we claim it, and that we can teach it, we can explain it simply enough and encourage others, that we let go of any form of arrogance or boastfulness or self, any sense of self, that we are so important to do anything for ourselves. And we understand, first and foremost, it is God and God alone, by the power of His Spirit, who brings salvation to us. And as such, we do the good works. And our good works is the evidence that the saving grace of Christ Jesus is in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
So now, we turn to our prayer books. On page 69, we recite the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lord, reveal your love among us,
that we may know the joy of your salvation.
Grant peace within and among all nations,
and teach our leaders wisdom.
Endow your church with faithfulness,
and her servants with knowledge and true godliness.
Defend, O Lord, the rights of the poor and the oppressed,
that your justice may be known among all people.
Lord, renew your spirit within us,
that in us and through us your will may be done.
We turn page 160, our collect for this week, page 160, the first Sunday after the Epiphany. Father in heaven, who at the baptism of Jesus in the River Jordan proclaimed him your beloved Son and anointed him with the Holy Spirit, grant that all who are baptized into his name may keep the covenant they have made and boldly confess him as Lord and Savior, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen. On page 71, we offer the first two prayers. Blessed are you, O Lord, the God of our fathers, creator of day and night, giving rest to the weary, renewing the strength of those who are spent, bestowing upon us occasions of song in the evening. As you have protected us in the day that is past, so be with us in the coming night. Free us from evil, sin, and fear. For you are our light and salvation and the strength of our life. To you be glory for endless ages. Amen. Lighten our darkness, Lord, we pray, and in your mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night, for the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. We continue in this time of prayer, sisters and brothers. In our prayer tonight, we indeed give thanks to God for this day and for the many blessings of the day. We pray that we would have made every effort to count our blessings, to acknowledge the good things God has done for us and for others this day. Indeed, we give him thanks, and we pray that we would not soon forget his goodness. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We offer our prayers this night. We continue to pray for the sick, those who ask for our prayers. In hospital, we remember this night to pray for Elvis Stevens. Prayers are also asked for Donna. We offer our prayers for our sister Pamela Tweed and for any others. I remember Ishmael. And any others in hospital at this time, we pray God's healing mercies upon them. Pray for their families. And pray for the physical and spiritual support to help to nurture them back to good health. We pray also for those who grieve and mourn. And tonight, indeed, our hearts are heavy as we remember those who have died and the family members who mourn and grieve their passing. We remember Valentine Thomas, laid to rest yesterday. Aisilma Basu. I remember in recent times, more recent times, Sylvia Duggins and Douglas Richardson, Dawn Richardson, all the families. We also remember our brother John Sweeney. We pray for all the families as they mourn and as they grieve. We pray and we give thanks for our sister Joycelyn tonight as she, I think, is now out of hospital. We pray for God's grace, continued grace and blessings in her life. We are asked, still in hospital. I'm sorry, Sister Joycelyn, still in hospital. Pray for God's continued mercies upon you. We ask to pray for Letitia Edmead, Mrs. Letitia Edmead. Pray for God's healing touch and God's healing mercies in her life. And we are asked to remember also in a special way the Bishop of Barbados, Bishop Michael Maxwell, as we have learned today that his dear wife has died. We pray for God, God's Holy Spirit, to indeed provide him and the family with the comfort, the strength that they would need during this very trying time. We remember the Diocese of Barbados, praying for the clergy and people there as they mourn with their shepherd. We pray that the soul of our departed sister, his wife, Sister Dawn, Dawn Maxwell, that her soul may rest in peace and at the appointed time rise in glory. We also pray for, continue to pray for the victims of domestic violence as we continue to pray and seek for ways and means to provide housing for victims, persons who have to flee their homes, for children who are caught up in these disputes. We pray for those with the means and we pray for our government that they would quickly seek to find ways and means to assist these hurting families and individuals in particular. And so as we offer our prayers for the victims, we also pray for the abusers, that they would have a change of heart, a different perspective on life. They would seek to amend their ways. And so we bring all before Almighty God this night. Tonight we're also praying for the recent double murder that we had. Was it last night? Or 2 nights ago, sorry. And so we pray for the souls of those two young men lost to gun violence. We give thanks to God indeed for our police, as we understand that they have been able to detain the guilty party. And so we pray for justice. We pray for justice. We pray for the aching hearts of mothers and family members over the death of these two young men. Lord, in your mercy.
Yeah.
We also pray for those who continue to work with our young people, not just our teachers in schools, but we pray for all of our counselors, our community workers, our community activists, all of our youth organizations and movements that do their best to provide avenues and means and opportunities for our young people. We pray for our young people to take hold of these opportunities so that they would allow their lives to become the better for it. We thank God for the various organizations and movements and opportunities that are offered for all who give themselves and avail themselves to work in for and with our young people. We pray that we will not become easily frustrated, but that we would dig in and we would take on the fight for the sake of the lives and future of our youth and indeed our nation. And so we pray this night, giving God thanks for our many and varied youth groups, youth movements and avenues and opportunities provided for our young people. We pray indeed for their hearts to be earnest and zealous enough to seek out these opportunities and to make good use of them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And so tonight we pray also for ourselves, that wherever we are, that we understand that we are the lights, we are the witnesses that our God depends upon. And so we pray that wherever we find ourselves this night, wherever we find ourselves tomorrow and the next day and the next, that we would be ever mindful of being the Christian lights and witnesses, the bearers of Christ to our world, proving and showing our world that there is indeed a God who is very real, that His Christ has come and has done marvelous things. Let us pray that wherever we go, we bring the assurance of God's salvation to the lives of others, that through our good works, we'll be a witness that our God is a good God. We pray for courage this night. We pray for grace upon grace to be who our God wants us to be, to become, to go through that process of transformation and become who we are created to become. Remember that we are created in Christ Jesus for good works. We place ourselves before God this night. And Lord, we pray this night, if there are any who plan mischief and evil, Lord, we pray that their plans would be frustrated. We pray, Lord, that their hearts will be turned. We pray that they would acknowledge that there has to be a better way. There has to be another way. And we pray, Lord, that they would seek earnestly for better. That they would not seek to prey upon and prowl upon those who labor and so hard for what they have. Lord, we pray this night for all evil plans to be frustrated, that the work of the enemy to be disrupted, to be thrown into confusion, and for the light of Christ to shine ever brightly, that all may see you, they may see the good works in this world, and they may come to the living God. All that we may fail to ask this night, dear God, we pray that you would grant to us in your mercy. And before we close, let us remember to offer a word of prayer for all who celebrate a birthday, anniversary, or any wonderful occasion at this time. We pray God's blessings upon them and pray that they would have a wonderful celebration this week. Okay, and so as we close our prayer, we thank God for all of His mercies, and we pray that indeed we would all rest peacefully in Christ, and by His will, that we may rise to see a new day, and with our eyes opened, we will also open our hearts wide to receive Jesus afresh and to go forth to do His will. We thank you, Lord, and we praise you in the same name of Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen. 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 And so, brothers and sisters, let us now turn to our hymn books, and we sing the hymn number 364. 364. We have good reason and good occasion to sing, for our salvation is very real. Come, Christians, join to sing. 364.
Christians join to sing, Alleluia, Amen. Loud praise to Christ our King, Amen.
Heaven's blissful shore, his goodness we'll adore, singing forevermore, Alleluia, Amen. On page 73, we have our prayer of dedication. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light to our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all persons in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May his divine assistance be with us always. And may the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. And at the appointed time, may they rise in glory. Amen. Thank you so much for sharing. A very pleasant and peaceful evening to you. And by God's grace, I pray that we will all rise to see a new day. Do take care, and we meet again on Friday morning, 6 a.m. God's blessings to all.